all we have is our attention, you know? This is all, you know, people often feel paralyzed in the face of the enormity of the world's problems, and we don't need to enumerate them. There's so many. But one thing that we have absolutely utter control of, and what everyone in the world is vying for, is our attention. You know, and our attention is aimable as part of consciousness. We can aim our attention. We can shine a flashlight on what we choose to. And there's not, when you start to unpack the nature of genetics and environment and prior causes and randomness, there's not a lot of room for free will, to be honest. And we have that seems to contradict the intuition as part of our, that exists as part of our lived experience. But really, when you begin to examine the nature of how things happen, there's not a lot of freedom. We all need to breathe, and that requires photosynthesis and, you know, plankton and all sorts of other things. So, but one thing we do seem to be able to control is where we put our attention moment to moment. And if we can investigate the nature of the mind such that we can direct our attention in ways that are positive, then that seems to create its own domino effect of prior causes. And for example, the more I meditate, the more equanimous and content and connected I feel, the more I put my attention towards community and the importance of fostering community, the more community I will make, I will generate or foster. And I think this is really important because people can get, and I consider myself part of people, people can get quite distracted in life. Certainly plenty of reason to be distracted. But if there's any advice that I can share with anyone, it's that really acknowledge the fact that you can control your attention. And when you begin to train your attention in a particular way, you begin to almost immediately see really beneficial results. And those results can be, you know, physiological, they can be professional, they can be relational.